Global climate talks are continuing in Poland as countries try to hash out a rule book to help implement the Paris Climate Accord. There are warnings the world is on track for at least 3 degrees of warming by the end of the century. Now researchers have evaluated what impact that scenario could have on flood levels. They looked at data from tens of thousands of rainfall stations and rivers and found that while climate change is causing heavier rainfall, river systems are actually declining. Ashish Sharma is a professor at the University of New South Wales School of Civil and Environmental Engineering and one of the researchers who worked on this report. Welcome to RN Breakfast.
Hi there.
I do want to get to the results in terms of what you found, but just the methodology, first of all, you're not looking just at modelling. You've looked at data from 160 countries measuring both rainfall and river levels. Why does that give us something different to what you would get from modelling?
Well, I guess there is one added element of uncertainty in the modeling because you have to assume a model structure, and especially making an assumption when you're doing it with regards to the future makes it a little unpalatable. And it's often models tend to disagree with other models. So data is something that is foolproof. Anybody can download it. Anybody can assess it using the same methodology. Assumptions are very few. So this becomes a lot more reliable.
So what is it that you've found? Because I suppose conventional wisdom has been that as climate change continues, we might get more rainfall, therefore we'll live in wetter environments. But actually, what you've discovered is the opposite.
That's precisely the case. So our expectation a priori was pretty much what you said, that we knew that a warmer atmosphere holds more rainfall. And when it all comes down, it becomes a bigger rainfall event, will cause a bigger flood. But when we started looking at data across the world, and even before that, when we started speaking to engineers and hydrologists, you know, all across Australia, they said that, hey, flood levels are actually reducing. They are not rising. And our analysis with this massive data set located across the world, excluding very clearly the urban environments, which have complicating factors because you're covering the landscape by concrete or, say, snow-covered catchments, it just says it out clearly that floods are on the decline rather than increasing.
So what's happening, though, to the soil? What's changing as a result of climate change?
What is happening is that warmer temperatures also cause more evaporation. And this evaporation means that the soil on which the rain falls is drier than it used to be before. And this is something that we hadn't really factored into that much of an extent, but we found it to be quite a clear case. So what happens is, if you take extreme rainfall events, and you see how many of those extreme rainfall events become extreme floods. On average, it's about 36%. That 36% big rainfall, extreme rainfall events will lead to floods. But this number changes dramatically depending on whether you are in a wet soil or a dry soil. With a dry soil, this number drops down to 13%. With wet soils, this number increases to 68%. And what is happening is suppose before you had an even scenario that the soils could be 50% wet, 50% dry. Right now, it's 60% dry and 40% wet. And this is a scenario that will continue to become more and more amplified, which will create problems.
So am I correct in understanding that even though we might be getting more rain, the Earth itself is becoming less capable of using that water in a productive fashion?
So what is happening is, because the soil is drier, when a big rainfall event comes along, a bigger proportion of that rainfall event ends up first soaking up the soil. Once the soil is sufficiently wet, then what we call surface overland flow, it starts happening. And this flow is the flow that we see coming into our rivers, which is what fills up our dams, which is what causes floods. And essentially, that's what is happening.
So what's the rate at which this change is occurring?
The rate is quite disconcerting. So we have been seeing that the very extreme, the life-threatening floods are actually increasing at the rate the rainfall is increasing, because the rainfall in these life-threatening floods is so high that the drier soils would not be able to compensate for the amount of rain that is coming along. But the frequent floods, the ones that are happening regularly, the recurrent floods that fill up our dams, that ensure our water supply, they seem to be going down between 10 to 15% across the world with each degree rise in temperature. And that's a big number, because we've already had about a 0.9 degree rise in temperature. And the expectations are that we will have a 3.5 degree rise in temperature by the year 2100. So you can do the calculations and see why this is possibly a bigger impact than the increase in floods that has been reported in the past. Because, I mean, water supply is something we need day in and day out. Floods impact us once off.
In Australia, we obviously live on one of the driest places on the planet. How severe are the impacts here that you've observed?
I believe the impacts are especially severe in the case of Australia. And the reason for that is Australia is a dry continent. Now, this R analysis does not take into account the projections of climate models of how rainfall might change. But the models do say that the dry areas will get drier, the wet areas will get wetter. So it's not like the entire world will be uniformly impacted. There will be spatial variabilities, but Australia is looking worse because our rainfall will also decrease. It will not increase. And as temperatures go up, the evaporation will increase. So this rainfall will lead to even lower floods, which will fill up our dams even to a lesser extent.
So obviously Australia's already having great difficulty distributing water from things like the Murray-Darling Basin. If these trends continue, what's likely the impact going to be on our agriculture?
The agricultural impact is profound, and I cannot overemphasize this thing. The reason for that is soils are drying up. When soils get dry, the farmers need more water to grow the crops. So basically what you're having is you're having a scenario where the inflows into the dams are decreasing. The demand for water is increasing by the farmers, then the whatever you store in the dams, that will be subject to more evaporation. It's like it's not a pleasant situation from any angle.
Does this discovery that you've been involved in making change the way we think about the impacts of climate change?
To some extent, it does, because the overwhelming consensus has been in the past that when rainfalls will increase, floods will increase. And this is what previous IPCC reports have noted down. And it pretty much is something that had been accepted, except for people in the water resources discipline who were actually handling the flood data. And they could see that only in the very small, in the very urban catchments, are you seeing this increase in floods. In the larger catchments, and say the Murray-Darling Basin, you are not seeing that. And this is what we have found out.
Ashish Sharma, it's been fascinating to listen to you this morning. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Ashish Sharma is a professor at the University of New South Wales School of Civil and Environmental Engineering.